Hello everyone, I am Dibyoti Ponda. In today's video lecture, I will tell you about spherical aberration, how to overcome this spherical aberration. Then I will give some example of use of spherical mirror. Okay, so let's begin. So spherical aberration, it is the inability of a spherical mirror of large aperture to bring all rays of wide beam of light falling on it to the focus at a single point is called spherical mirror. It's called spherical aberration. Okay, so everyone know the beam which are falling upon parallel beam which are falling upon a spherical mirror, it will converge at focus for a concave mirror. In a convex mirror, they are seems that they are diverging from focus. So if in our previous case we assume that the mirror is having small aperture, okay, in small aperture there is no problem, all beams are converged at certain point. But in case of mirror, spherical mirror having large aperture, the beam of light actually not converge at certain point. Then not so that inability of that mirror is called spherical aberration. So listen this figure, this see this figure, see this paraxial rays. Paraxial rays means these rays are passing very close to the principal axis. So these paraxial rays, these paraxial rays are converging at the focus. This all four rays are converging at focus. But this marginal ray means the ray is passing very far away from the focus. So this marginal ray is not converging at focus, although it is parallel to the principal axis. So why this is not converging? Because the mirror is having large aperture. So this inability of the mirror is called spherical aberration. So spherical aberration can be reduced by following method. They are by using spherical mirror of small aperture, that is we have used previously. Okay, we have considered previously. By using stopper so as to cut off the marginal ray. See in this diagram, I have used stopper for a concave mirror. See, the beam of light is passing parallel to the principal axis. So this stopper are cutting off this stopper. They are cutting the marginal ray, and only paraxial ray are getting reflected from the mirror, and they are converging at focus. Then by using parabolic mirror, see by using parabolic mirror, so this is a parabolic mirror. Mirror is having parabolic shape. See, everyone know this is a parabola or this is a parabola. Okay, so parabolic mirror is a parts of what, or it's shaped like parabola. Then see in this parabolic concave mirror, see beam of light is passing parallel to the principal axis. See the paraxial ray, this ray are converging at focus, this ray are converging at focus, this ray also converging at focus, this ray also converging at focus. Again see the marginal ray means the ray which are passing far away from the principal axis. So this marginal ray, they are also converging at focus. So by using a concave parabolic mirror, we can overcome the spherical aberration. See, I have written over here, in a parabolic mirror the wide parallel beam will focus onto a single point upon the principal axis, and the spherical aberration is reduced. Then use of concave mirror. Okay, that is concave mirror, convex mirror and parabolic mirror. So first one is concave mirror. A concave mirror is used as a saving or makeup mirror because it forms a magnified and erect image of the face when it held closer to the face. So, सबको पता है कि वेन एवर एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज प्लेस इन बिटवीन पोल एंड फोकस ऑफ ए कॉन्केव मिरर वी गेट अ वर्चुअल इमेज एंड द इमेज इज इरेक्ट इन नेचर एंड मैग्नीफाइड इमेज वी गेट अ मैग्नीफाइड इमेज मीन्स द इमेज इज वेरी वेरी लार्जर देन द ऑब्जेक्ट लार्जर देन द ऑब्जेक्ट सो वेन एवर यू यू आर गोइंग टू ए वट बार्बर शॉप यू सी योर फेस बिहाइंड द मिरर एंड इट इज वेरी वेरी दैट इज अ लार्ज साइज दैट दैट ऑफ योर रेगुलर फेस So, in a concave mirror, the concave mirror we use the concave mirror as a shaving or makeup mirror. Okay, then second one, doctor use concave mirror as head mirror. The mirror is strapped to the doctor's forehead, and light from a lamp after reflection from the mirror is focused into the throat or ear of the patient. See, this is a doctor head lamp. Doctor, the ENT surgeon, they used to wear this head lamp upon their head. So they used to wear this head lamp upon their head, and in front of the doctor there is a source of light. So they place the reflecting surface in such a way that the lights each will get converged and they focus that light into the patient ear or throat. A small concave mirror with a small hole at its center is used in doctors ophthalmoscope. The doctor look through the hole from behind the mirrors while a beam of light from a lamp reflected from it is directed into the pupil of patient's eye which make the retina visible. So you may have seen this type of device is called ophthalmoscope during checking of your eye at eye hospital. Okay, so this also use the concept of concave mirror. So then four one, concave mirror are used as a reflectors in headlights of cars, railway engines, torchlights, etc. The source are placed at the focus of the concave reflector and the light rays after reflection travel over a large distance as a parallel intense beam. So, अब सबको पता है फोकस में अगर हम ऑब्जेक्ट को रखेंगे दैट्स मीन वी गेट द इमेज एट इनफिनिट और वी गेट एन लार्ज इमेज ओके अगर फोकस में हम लाइट सोर्स को रखेंगे दैट्स मीन वी गेट स्ट्रेट रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट ठीक ठीक है देन यूज ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स मिरर A convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror in automobiles. The reason is that it always forms a small and erect image and it has a large field of view than that of plane mirror of same size. See, this is a plane mirror and this is a convex mirror. See, for a plane mirror the view angle is very small, that of the convex mirror. See, for a convex mirror you have a large field view means we are able to the mirror is able to see very very large view of the object so it will capture a large field view then use of parabolic mirror a concave parabolic mirror can focus a wide parallel beam to a single point this property used by dish antennas to collect and bring to focus microwave signals from the street lights then second one when source of light is placed at the focus of parabolic mirror the reflected ray become accurately parallel and can be thrown over a large distance due to this property the parabolic mirror are used as the reflector of searchlight car headlight, etc. Okay, then third one, it used in astronomical telescope of large aperture to overcome spherical aberration. So during the class I will explain very details about this topic, then we will solve numerous problems. Okay, thank you.